Of course, in reality, we don't know whether a person suffers cancer, but we can run a test, like a blood test. And the outcome of the blood test may be positive or negative, but like any good test, it tells me something about the thing I really care about, whether the person is cancerous or not. So let's say if the person has the cancer, the test comes up positive with a probability of 0.9. And that implies if the person has cancer, the negative outcome would have a 0.1 probability. And that's because these two things have to add up to one. I've just given you a fairly complicated notation that says the outcome of the test depends on whether the person has cancer or not. That is more complicated than everything else we talked about so far. We call this thing over here a conditional probability. And the way to understand this is through this very funny notation. There's a bar in the middle, and the bar says, what's the probability of the stuff on the left, given that we assume the stuff on the right is actually the case? Now, in reality, we don't know whether the person has cancer or not, and in a later unit, we're going to reason about whether the person has cancer given a certain data set. But for now, we assume we have godlike capabilities. We can tell with absolute certainty whether the person has cancer, and we can determine what the outcome of the test is. This is a test that isn't exactly deterministic. It makes mistakes, but it only makes a mistake in 10% of the cases, as illustrated by the 0.1 down here. Now, it turns out I haven't fully specified the test. The same test might also be applied to a situation where the person does not have cancer. So this little thing over here is my shortcut of not having cancer. And now, let me say the probability of the test giving me a positive result, a false positive result, when there's no cancer, is 0.2. You can now tell me what's the probability of a negative outcome in case we know for a fact the person doesn't have cancer. So please tell me.